Please subscribe.
At the point when car makers present another model, one may anticipate that it should be all new. Despite the fact that the 2019 Honda Passport denotes the restoration of a model name Honda last utilized 16 years back on a mellow 4x4 fan that was extremely an identification designed Isuzu Rodeo, its genuine mission is to conquer any hindrance in Honda's lineup between the reduced CR-V and the 3-push Pilot. This all-new Passport is basically precisely indistinguishable from its Pilot stablemate, just shorter and without the way back seat situate. This is no awful thing, if not actually new. Inspiration originates from Honda's pervasive 280-horsepower SOC 3.5-liter V6. Floor the quickening agent, and the EVTEC without a doubt kicks in. The sole transmission accessible is the as-of-late refreshed ZF-sourced 9-speed programmed. It now downshifts with more desperation, however we sense there's still some crisper snap concealed away in the crate. Indeed, even with Ute's oxygen-meager air-sapping torque, the powertrain mix felt more than satisfactory for the Passport, which, at 4,265 pounds for the elite model we tried, is just 35 pounds lighter than an also-prepared Pilot. The Passport requires simply 5.8 seconds to arrive at 60 miles per hour, which is 0.2 seconds snappier than its bigger-kin and a large portion of a second in front of the all-new and all the more dominant Chevrolet Blazer RS. In light of a legitimate concern for effectiveness, the V6 factory can deactivate three of its chambers, and the back drive shaft decouples under light burden when torque to drive the back wheels isn't required. The Passport's mileage falls about mid-pack, accomplishing a joint EPA gauge of 22 miles per gallon in front-wheel drive models and 21 miles per gallon when furnished with all-wheel drive. At the point when stretched as far as possible through Southern California's valleys, the Passport restored an unremarkable 17 miles per gallon. We anticipate that this number should increment when driven with more restriction. Intense sky Honda rushes to publicity the Passport's rough terrain slashes, and the contention may convey a slender, store slice cut of meat to it. Our test vehicle was the TropSpec Elite trim that accompanies standard all-wheel drive. It's a $1,900 choice on lesser trim levels. Albeit genuine rough terrain devotees will take note of that the Passport does not have any underbody securing slip plates. The AWD Passport's 8.1 crawls of ground leeway, front drive models have 7.5 creeps of freedom, is accomplished by the utilization of taller springs. The improved article clearing edges, approach, breakover, and flight, give more shake crawling capacity than Passport proprietors are probably going to require, and the ducklet demonstrated fit for gentle rough terrain outings along Moab's less voyaged ways. At the point when furnished with all-wheel drive, the intelligent variable torque management (IVTM4) highlights normal, sand, snow, and mud drive mode settings that amazingly divert torque to the wheels that need it. The IVTM4 framework likewise gives genuine torque vectoring through the back differential, not some brake-based framework which enables it to send 100% of the torque coordinated to the back hub to either back wheel when required. All Passports accompany 20-inch wheels, and the 265/45R20 Continental Cross Contact LX Sport Elastic on the elite models we drove vanquished sand, mud, ice, and broken shake without hardly lifting a finger. However, they probably won't be the best size for genuine rough terrain adventuring. The Sport and XL are fitted with 245/50R20 tires. The wheels look attractive, yet there is some bumping over rugged territory when conveying unassuming pace. One oversight, considering Honda's accentuation on rough terrain capacity, is that the Passport needs slope drop control. Luckily, the brake pedal is firm, and the exhibition is sufficient for its group, requiring 181 feet to prevent from 70 miles per hour on asphalt. The Passport drives a great deal like a Pilot. The controlling rack's somewhat snappier proportion still feels slow as cue and padded light from lock to secure, yet is exact its movements. Also, there's basically no veiling the Honda's transcending focal point of gravity during brisk advances. Hustling the Passport through twisty gulches resembles playing vehicular Jenga. Despite the fact that its humble body fit wasn't sufficient to discourage us from pushing it through corners, the 0.78 grams of sidelong hold is a long way from noteworthy and is restricted by a meddlesome dependability control framework. Like the Ridgeline and the Pilot, front-wheel drive Passports are appraised to tow 3,500 pounds and all-wheel drive models are equipped for pulling 5,000 pounds. However, simply after a couple of vendor-introduced adornments, including a trailer hitch, $360, wiring outfit, $225, and transmission cooler, $385, are included that open the most extreme tow rating. Seeing things from the front seat, the dashboard, the controlling wheel, and the middle support are reminiscent of the Pilot's since they are shared. The front seats and their going-with armrests give an abnormal state of solace. The back seat base slides fore and toward the back, and the backrest tilts, so it's similarly pleasing. The Passport's square-shaped inside is a help for freight volume, flaunting a copious 78 cubic feet with the back seats collapsed and 41 blocks with them upstanding. There's additionally a liberal measure of stowage underneath the back burden floor. The base level Passport Sport begins at $33,035 and incorporates LED lighting at all four corners, remote begin, and a little infotainment screen. The $37,455 XL trim includes a 8.0-inch touchscreen with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay similarity, calfskin upholstery, and a power lift gate. For $40,325, the touring trim includes warm detachable back seats, rooftop rails, and front and back stopping sensors. Our tried elite space cost of $44,725 offers ventilated front seats, a warm directing wheel, and inductive telephone charging. With the previously mentioned towing hardware, the S-Tride value comes in at $45,695. All Passports profit by standard Honda sensing, a large group of electronic security frameworks, for example, versatile journey control, forward impact caution, and path-keeping help. Outwardly, the Passport mixes components of both the Honda Ridgeline pickup and the Pilot. Its front belt looks, somewhat, more forceful than that pair's, and the back is particular. The 2-push Passport's body estimates 6.5 inches shorter than the 3-push Pilot's regardless of all-wheel drive models riding on the equivalent 111.0-inch wheelbase. FWD models have a somewhat shorter wheelbase. To call everything new may be somewhat liberal, however the 2019 Honda Passport certainly fulfills its main goal and ought to most likely fulfill Honda's coffers as a skilled and common-sense center ground in Honda's center hybrid lineup.